Hello, cruising world. Mick the Suit Guy with you. Quick intro, quick outro. I've been doing a lot of traveling this year. I have a lot of ports to show you. Rather than waste a lot of time on these intros, I want to get to the meat and potatoes, as we say in England, of the port. So I'm just going to introduce each port by the area in one suit. It'll be the same intro for each one. The headline or the title of the video will tell you where we're going to do. But this one is going to be somewhere. I was on Celebrity Solstice. We went from Hong Kong to Singapore via some places in Vietnam and Thailand. So this video is going to be one of them. Look at the headline. Look at the subject matter. You know where we're going to go. We're going there right now. All right, we are heading to Hanoi, but we are in the port of Halong Bay. So what you'll find is a lot of these ports, the cities where we're going to don't have ports large enough to take cruise ships just yet. So there will be ports up there, but they'll only take the smaller ships because they're just not built yet for the larger ones. So we're on Celebrity Solstice. We're getting off in Halong Bay and we're going to meet our guide and he's going to take us all the way to Hanoi for a tour for the day. Now, all these buses you can see on the left, they are all the official ship tour buses. If you watch this channel enough, you will know we never do ship tours. Well, unless we absolutely have no choice. We just don't believe in them. We'll leave that there. I have many reasons I'm not going to go into. But we have to head to the very front of the port. So it is quite a long way to get there. You can walk if you wish. Or they do have little shuttle buses that will take you there and back. But on this occasion, we decided to walk. But it is a long walk, as you're going to see. This little yellow kind of shuttle busy thing here, that is what would take you to the front. So if you just want to wait for one of those and jump in, they will take you all the way up there. We could have had better weather, of course. It's not the nicest, is it? It's very overcast. I can't even get the right words out today. Now, the next day, we actually did a boat trip, and it was even worse, which was a big shame because kind of sport the views, but what can you do? So now we are looking back. This is actually looking forward to the front, and you'll see there's an amazing cable car going over and a ferris wheel at the other end. And there's the ship. Those cable cars take over 200 people, I was told. Now, where those people are walking, and you can see that bike coming back the other way, that's where we would have walked to keep going. I just wanted to pop over here to get the best view of that cable car. But we're just basically going to keep walking up here. That yellow building is where we're headed. So as you can see, yes, it is a long way. But here comes one of those shuttle buses that you could easily get if you wanted to. A lot of people, because this was an overnight stop, a lot of people would actually go and stay overnight in Hanoi and come back the next morning. We chose not to because we wanted to do a tour of Halong Bay. And we actually did one of these boats, as you can see. You won't believe the price. We actually got a private one of these for like $150, including an amazing dinner. It was unbelievable. Can't recommend that enough. Do a private one. Or, you know, if you want, you can do a ship one where they'll charge you the same money and you can join 25, 30 of your best friends. We'll leave that one there again. All right, this is the main area you're going to go for private tours. Like I said, it's a good long walk from the ship. So if you need to get those tourists, get the trams, you can see them up there on the right. And that's where they'll drop you off. And when you get here, your tour guides will all be waiting for you. Ours was just inside, so he was easy for us to find. So once you find your tour guide, they're going to take you wherever it is you want to go. I'm going to show you a few little clips of us getting into Hanoi on the way up there. Some nice countryside, as you'll see. So there's one of the tour buses leaving. There's all the way back there. You can see in the far distance is the ship. And there's those shuttle buses. So we've now found our guide and we are heading into Hanoi. Once we get there, I'm going to show you the most common thing you'll see in Hanoi, which is mopeds, motorbikes. Even the taxis are motorbikes. We call them grab. And look out for the little kid that flicks off the other kid. Look out for people crossing the road there because you don't wait. You just go and people stop for you. It's very interesting. And I decided I'll show you a little clip of them here and then I'm going to put it to some music. Hopefully it doesn't get copyrighted. We'll see. But yeah. This is the calm before the storm. Watch out for the kid, watch out for people crossing the road, and just watch out for bikes in general.
Bicycle, bicycle, bicycle. I want to ride my
bicycle, bicycle.
say white,
say bar, I say bite,
say shark,
I say
him, and Jaws was never my scene, and I don't like Star Wars.
Say Rose,
I say Royce,
say God,
give me a choice.
Say Lord,
I say Christ, I don't believe in Peter Pan, Frankenstein or Superman.
All I wanna do is
us on a rickshaw at the end. More rickshaw action coming shortly, but now I'm going to show you some of the sights we saw in Hanoi itself, which the vast majority of which was temples. Very, very important to the local people. We were there to learn the local culture, so we wanted to do all we could to get to know about it, and a very large part of that is the religion. So a lot of Buddhists in these areas. There's our guide right in front of us there, doing a wonderful job. He was brilliant. And this is one of the temples he took us to. A recurring theme in all the places we went to, we probably went to about 30 or 40 temples, I'm not exaggerating, during the time we between Hong Kong and Singapore. They are everywhere, but it's fine. It's very important. Like I said, a lot of houses have their own private temples. So we saw a lot of places on the side of the street selling them. So I know what I'll do if I ever go over there. I'll sell them. But this is just one of them. As you can see, they're all very elaborate, very popular touristy destinations, lots of people taking pictures, but there's also a lot of people there for religious reasons. A lot of local people that are there to pray and worship and all that good stuff. So it's not just tourists, I promise you. And we were lucky enough to be allowed inside. Normally we are not allowed inside these areas, we noticed on most of these places. But this particular one, we were allowed to... No, when I say not inside, we could go inside, but we couldn't take video or pictures, is what I meant. I apologize. You can go inside them all. And most of them, you have to take your shoes off. Some of them make you put little bags over your feet as well to keep the floor clean, which is absolutely understandable and fine. If you're not ready for that, don't do it. They also have a lot of places nearby if you want to dress in local gear, local outfits, that they actually rent them to you for the time. Religion is so important. All these school children had their graduation ceremony here. As you can see, they're all lined up ready to go, and some of them wanted to take their pictures with us. So who am I to say no? So we had some of the girls at the back, there they are, saying hello. We all took pictures together, and then we did a rickshaw ride. You know I love my music, so we're going to put it to rest. Really giving you an idea of what the streets look like, more than the bikes earlier. although you'll see a lot of bikes. But these are the streets of Hanoi. Restaurants, shops, all sorts. And yes, I did walk across the street on my own. And it was a bit scary. A main junction, that is, but I did it. I don't think the rickshaw driver was too happy when he saw us because, well, we both put some weight on, that's all I'll say. But this gives you a feel for a daily life in Hanoi. Easily more bikes than cars, and sometimes they don't care which way they go. One-way streets mean nothing. A lot of shops selling items like this. Very cheap to buy souvenirs as well. They like the color red, can you tell? Crazy bikes. We just wanted to turn left, we don't care. How would you feel driving here? They're used to it. There we are, in a rickshaw, with our driver, looking happy as hell. All right, now my favorite part of the day, we were waiting to see the train. You see all the people near the edge of the track. They're having a drink, they're having some food. Once the train is getting near, they blow whistles, and all of a sudden, everybody has to move. As you can see, all the chairs are moved back. Everybody's blowing whistles, going crazy. Within 5 seconds of the train passing through, those tables will be back where they were before. Here comes the train. I will let it do the talking. Listen out for Julie. Oh lordy, Julie! They do a night one of these, can you imagine when you've been drinking? This, we headed back to Halong Bay. That's the highlight of our trip to Hanoi. If you go, try and catch this train. That's all I will say. There she goes, and the tables will come back out immediately. Hope you enjoyed that little video of our trip through Hanoi. Alright, there you are. That was a port somewhere between Hong Kong and Singapore. Again, look at the subject. Or you just watched it. You know where it was. But yeah, I don't need to go waffling on and on. I'm just going to say, if you enjoyed that video, please subscribe to this lovely little channel. It's a little channel, I will admit. Hit the button if you want to be notified. The bell, rather, if you want to be notified when these videos come out. Leave a like, leave a comment, or whatever. I will reply to all comments. And if you have any questions, please email me. My email is coming up in a second. If you have any traditions or cruising tips, please send them to me. I do a cruising tip and traditions video every Monday. Every Thursday, I put out a cabin video. And every Saturday, a video like this. So hopefully that was helpful. Hopefully you enjoyed it. And hopefully you get to go to whatever that port was. Because it was wonderful. Because I've never been to a bad one. Well, yeah, a couple. Not on this cruise, though. I see you later, cruising world.
Any questions? Email me anytime, cruisingsuitguy@gmail.com. I promise I'll reply as soon as possible. Want to book a cruise or any type of travel? We are travel agents. Check out our site, elitetravelconnection.com, or email me, mick@elitetravelconnection.com. We are here for you. Finally, subscribe, please. Pretty please. You know you want to. Go on. I won't beg you. Okay, I'm begging. Please. Subscribe! Thank you.